Jesus. Let's pray now. Rapasika talabahaya. Ande brosa mashta mahaya. Abashete liba ande bosotoya. Bahaya mazukaria. Ando shete bohuya. Apapapaye libahaya. Yeah, my Father, my God. As we pray for our children tonight, the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, they need to turn them loose. Jesus Christ of Nazareth, and whom the Son set free is free indeed. Thank you for their deliverance tonight. Stand in the gap tonight on the behalf of children. We thank you, O God, for every breakthrough. God of heaven, remember our sons. Remember our daughters tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lord, we bless your name. Glorify your name. We thank you tonight. Hallelujah, for their deliverance. In Jesus' mighty name. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The blood healed, the blood delivered, the blood set them free. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Grace to be a success. Every plan of the enemy against the life of our daughters tonight, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, we thank you for their deliverance. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, bring every struggle before you. Declare that they are a success. They are a success. They will succeed in every area in their life. Send them destiny helpers.
Father, I pray that our sons and our daughters will be business owners. They will be influential in government. They will be influential in their nations, in this nation. They will have success. They will become business owners. Multi-millionaires, billionaires. I thank you for blessing them so they can be a blessing, a generation. In the name of Jesus, thank you for their deliverance tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Give them favor, Lord. Favor. You said the heart of the king is in the hands of the Lord. Sends it wherever he pleases, like rivers of living water. We take control over the heart of man. We command their heart to submit to the grace of God that's upon our lives. In the name of Jesus, thank you for favor. There are some men that God have called to nations. Things will not change in certain places until they arrive. Leaders, creation is waiting for you to manifest leaders. That's why I'm here to empower you, to push you. There are things in your environment that are waiting for you to speak. The word of God is in your mouth. I cannot touch those people. You can. God has shifted us into another dimension tonight. You are not the old person they knew, preachers, ministers they knew. Next time when a crisis is presented to you, you see how, watch how you're going to handle it. The people that are with you are going to be shocked. As you open your mouth, change will begin to take place. to pray. Not pray when you are in trouble. Not pray when you have a need. Not pray when you need a miracle. It says pray without
ceasing.
You're supposed to pray all the time while you're driving.
That's
the
right.
Car, you're supposed to pray. Are you with me in here? Why are you cooking? You're supposed to pray.
Because
apart from your husband and your children, if your children walk into the house and the enemy did something to them, you want to be able to pray over the food and serve it to them. It doesn't matter what's going on in their body. As they eat the food, they will be healed. Have a supernatural encounter with God.
Yes.
Don't give somebody a cup of water without speaking, releasing a word.
They drink the juice, they can be delivered, they can be sent to power.
Your house, your uncle has cancer. Before you feed him, you pray over the food. You say, Lord, I see cancer is going to dry out. As he eats the food, before he leaves, the cancer can disappear.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening. Wow. I like that. That sounds like a do-over right there. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hey, happy Thanksgiving, everybody. Happy
Thanksgiving.
I know I can smell y'all's cooking. I can smell it. My God. We got some great cooks on this line. So look, before we even get started into this midweek service of testimonies and the blessings of God happening in all of our lives, I just want to give the Lord thanks. I just want to tell him, thank you. Father, thank you for this opportunity. Thank you for this platform. Thank you for Apostle Gene Elias. Thank you for all the families represented on this line today and throughout all the years, God. Thank you for all of the leaders that are on this line and that are here in the Altar Church International. I want you to know, God, that my thanksgiving and my praise belong unto you, God, for what you have done in each one of our lives and how you blessed us mightily. I am excited about what you're doing. I'm excited about the corner that we've just
Hallelujah.
and the, yes, the outpour, yes, of the blessings that are upon, yes, each of our lives that are on this line. Yes. I thank you for all of our obedience, God,
that you
have done in our hearts. We thank you for aligning us alongside your servant, Apostle Dean Elias, yes, that we can lift up his hands. We can lift up his arms, God, so that he can be right there for you. On top of everything that's concerning you,
in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen and amen. My heart is filled with thanksgiving and praise unto the Lord. I tell you what, it's a blessing. It's a blessing, you all. For each one of you, your voices to be heard. It is a tremendous blessing if each one of your faces was on the line. That would be incredible as well. I'm telling you, but I realize some people can't let their pictures be shown, but that's okay. But I just want you to know that even sometimes just to look on your face gives somebody encouragement. Just the smile that you exhibit on your mind gives somebody encouragement. I'm telling you. Amen. Some people that haven't seen you for a long time, they look at you and say, oh my God, that girl looks good. That's right. Amen. She's growing in grace and she's aging in beauty. That's right.
Let them know
what's going on. God bless all of you. Some of you I've known for a long time. And I am so grateful for each one of you. We have to reflect back. This is a time of family. This is a time of celebration. This is a time of giving God thanks. And I just want to thank God for you. I want to thank God.
Amen. Thank God for you as well.
That's for sure. Well, look, is it, moderator, before we jump into this word, I want to know, is there any testimonies on this line? Because you know, midweek service, we began with testimonies. We began with testimonies, and then we have to jump into prayer because we've got to open the atmosphere for Apostle Gene Elias to come in here and bring us to a new level. I'm excited about how he's been teaching us, you all.
Amen.
I'm excited. I'm excited and I'm greedy. I want more and more and more and more.
Amen.
More and more. My God. Yes. Is there any testimonies tonight?
Dr. Denise.
Oh, yes. Okay. Come on, Prophetess Abigail.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening.
Good evening. Good evening, darling.
I won't be long. I just wanted to touch base for what has happened on last Friday. It was an experience none like no other. I want to just say, first of all, honor. I just want to read one scripture, Exodus 20 and 12, honor. Honor your father and mother. That your days, okay? Then you will live. This is coming from the New Living Translation. It says, honor your father and mother. Then you will live a long life, full life in the land the Lord, your God, is giving you.
Wow.
I'm sorry. I honor Apostle Gene Elias in my life.
Amen.
What has transpired over the years, it's called pain in the process. If you want to get to where God wants you to be, it's going to take great pain. But if you follow the instructions and you claim that Apostle Gene Elias is your man of God, then follow the instructions that is given to you. What happened on Friday night was a blessing. The whole, matter of fact, I won't even say Friday, the whole time I was there was a major blessing. From the time I left home all the way to the time I came back home was blessing on top of blessing on top of blessings.
Thank you.
God has given us a man of God. And those of you who sit back and take it lightly and look at this as religion and not a relationship, the train is moving. That's what I'm going to say. The train is moving. Matter of fact, the train has already left the station. And if you can't grab hold of that train, I'm sorry, you've missed it. All of the years that Apostle has been feeding us and feeding us. This is for the older ones. And I'm sorry for you new people who are just coming on the line. God bless you. I'm glad y'all are grabbing on, holding on and running with it. I'm glad y'all are running with it. But I thank God. And Friday night was awesome. Friday night was like none other. Many of you watch it from Los Angeles, but to see it in Miami, when God has, well, how God has used, well, has God has used Prophet Lovey, our grandfather, speaking the word over these people and the manifestations that came from this situation. I mean, just awesome. To see these people literally stand before this great man of God. We take that word fire lightly. We say fire because we're told to say fire, but you really know what fire means. The devil hates that word. He hates it greatly. When you use that word fire, he cringes. All he did was stand there. Prophet Lovey was fire. And these people manifested. He spoke and they manifested. But he did not get there without process. I say to you all, follow the instructions of your man of God if you claim him to be your man of God. You've heard, I'm not going to hold you, you've heard other testimonies already about what has happened Friday night. But for me, I've been blessed the entire time that I went. I sacrificed. That's a big word. Many of you, sacrifice is what's going to get you the blessings that God has for you. If you don't, again, you've missed that train. But I'll say to you again, God bless you all. And you all enjoy the rest of the service. And when the man of God comes, take it. Don't take it lightly. Listen to what he says, if he's your man of God. Amen.
That's right, Prophetess Abby. Amen. Thank you so much for your testimony. Thank you so much. I could have, I remember Prophetess Natalie said it was like liquid fire.
Yes.
Like liquid fire. Yes. And it's absolutely incredible. Absolutely incredible how God uses our, Prophet Lovey. He's such a man. My heart goes out to him. I love that man. I love what God is doing in his life. I love what God, the leadership that he has given Apostle Gene Elias. I love that fathering. I really do. And how many of you have seen a difference in your life because of that relationship between those
Amen.
Two?
Amen.
Yes.
Most definitely there's been a change in my life because of that relationship, and we celebrate that. We should celebrate it daily.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Daily we should celebrate it daily. Amen. Is there yet another testimony that we have that's here on the Zoom? I'm looking to see what's happening. Yes mother.
How you doing, Pastor Denise?
Yes, marvelous.
Praise the Lord, everyone.
I thank God for my health and my life and my strength. And I give honor to Apostle August Elias. You know, it's kind of hard to drop the August sometimes because you've been used to it for a very long time. But I thank God for the Elias family. That includes me now, y'all. Yes. And I'm so excited about it. I was not physically in Miami, but spiritually, I was there.
Yeah.
I was praying. I was casting. I was doing everything our father, Prophet Gene Elias, has taught us to do.
That's right.
Even though we didn't put our hands in, but we sent it. It was awesome. It was very awesome. I'm so happy to be a part of it. Oh God, it was so awesome. And to actually see our Papa drown those people with water, like they were being baptized in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
He didn't hold back that water, y'all. Did y'all see that?
Yeah.
Flash.
Yes.
They were being purged. They were being
flash.
You know, them spirits were coming out. Oh, God is so awesome. to use those vessels like that.
Amen.
Oh my God, that means he trusts them.
Yes.
God trusts them. Yes.
Amen.
All those people were freed. Those now are our brothers and sisters. Some were already there, but you know what they, you know. But they back. Glory to God, they back. Hallelujah. But I'm so grateful to be here. It's good to see you, Pastor. And happy Thanksgiving to you as well.
Oh,
Enjoy it. I don't have to cook, praise God. I got an invitation to go out. I'm going to take that invitation.
That's right. Take it.
Bring a plate home. Okay, well, thank you for allowing me to share what I had on my heart. Thank you all. God bless you. And Prophetess Abigail, you're right, girl. You may call it a train, but I'm flying with that eagle.
Amen.
Yes.
Thank y'all.
Thank you. Prophetess Hannah. Boy, I tell you what, is there yet another before we get into this word? We gotta open up the oh my Lord, look at this.
I think Siku.
But come on, Minister Tamar.
Praise the Lord. First, I want to honor God who is ahead of my life. I honor you, Mother Denise. I honor our Apostle Gene Elias, the man of God, the voice of God in my life. And I honor Grandpa, Prophet Elias. Amen. An awesome man of God. I, too, must agree with Prophetess Abigail that Friday night was just amazing. It was awesome to see up front and personal the move of God, the power of God, and just how the Lord, as she said, trust them, amen, to be used by him. Just it was just awesome, almost speechless. But my testimony is Apostle had, he has given me several words, but when he gives me a word, I grab hold to it, you know, I meditate on it, and I receive it. And he had told me that me and my children would celebrate for the holiday. And we're doing just that. My oldest son, he's a model, he's an actor, he's an author. And about 3 years ago, it's said that when the Lord wants to bless you, he sends a person in your life. When the enemy wants to destroy you, he sends a person in your life. So it takes discernment. And he had a young lady to come in his life, and she tried to literally destroy his life. But I took the word of God. I followed the instructions of the apostle, just trying to do everything I needed to do. He would always tell us to, you know, have your altar, pray for your children, sow for them. And that's what I've been doing. And today my son is here, he's home, and we're celebrating Thanksgiving. I also want to give God glory because the Lord blessed my daughter with a job. And she's making like double what she was making before. She changed careers. And all of that is from the man of God, Apostle, sharing and giving instructions. And as long as you follow them, as long as you do what you're told, amen, the Lord will answer your prayers. Yeah. And I'm standing here today on Thanksgiving is tomorrow, but I'm giving thanks today because he is answering my prayers. He is answering those things. I'm just enjoying, you know, requesting things of the Lord, and he's just answering the prayers, and he's changing my life. As Mother said, when you have that relationship, amen, with the Apostle, and that relationship with Papa Lovey, amen, we can walk in that grace and we can enjoy those things that God has promised us. And I'm just enjoying the promises of God. And I want to just say, I honor you, Apostle. I honor you, Mother. And I honor Grandpa, because I'm really soaking in the word that I'm receiving. and I'm trying to go higher, go from faith to faith and from glory to glory. And I'm experiencing that. And I just want to say thank you. Thank you.
God bless you, darling.
For being my leaders. Amen.
God bless you, darling. God bless you. This is incredible. God bless you. Is there yet one other? Is there yet one other? Because we want to make sure that we get this time in before the Lord so that we can, so that the blessings of God will be permeated all over this airways, all over the global network that Apostle has for us here. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Come on, buddy. Come on, CQ. Come on in.
I just want to thank God just for being on reminding me. I remember 2 years ago at the start of the pandemic, I was told that I wasn't going to catch this corona. And I've been saying throughout corona, and I said yes. Today, and God just reminded me of how close I've been to areas and people around it. And I just thank God just for giving me.
You know what, darling? We can't hear you all that good. Your connection. Yeah, your connection is not really clear. We're hearing like every other word. We're hearing every other word. So I tell you what, your testimony is extremely important. I want to get that testimony. Can you go out and come back in? Because that connection is not good. Is everybody else having that same experience where you're hearing little bits and pieces? Bits and pieces. That testimony is important to us. Can you go back in and can you try it again? Yep, go back in and try it again. I'm going to go to prayer, and then we're going to bring in Apostle, and we're going to call you for your testimony before we go off, okay? Because that's extremely important to us. Because I've never heard him testify before. Have you all heard him testify
before?
No.
Yeah, that's what I want to hear this. I want to hear it. Can you unmute? Mr. Campbell, let me see what's happening now, real quick. I think his system is not good. Okay, well, you all look, turn in your Bibles, those of you that have your Bibles, turn to Psalms 119. Psalms 119, and we're going to pray, and we're going to pull on that mantle of Apostle Gene Elias so that he can bless us, and so the Word of God can become alive, that we can be astute as to what the Lord is saying now. Because you know, God gives a refreshing word. He gives a new word every day. Psalms 119. Amen. Psalms 119. You know that this particular psalm is a wisdom psalm. And it's according to the alphabet, the Hebrew alphabet. And the Hebrew alphabet, it just breaks it down. And each section of eight, verses, it brings you to a new dimension of that particular alphabet. But we're going to go to Psalms, to 119 verse 57, and I'm going to read 58, and I may get down to 59 if we have time. You are my portion, O Lord. And that's what's going to be our prayer request today, that God, you are our portion, and that the blessings of God are going to be over our lives. So I tell you what, let's do this. I will promise to obey your word, and I have sought your face with all my heart. Be gracious to me according to thy promise. That's right. Be gracious to us according to thy promise. According to thy promise. All right. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, come on, everybody, unmute your line. Let's go before God.
First of all, we bless the name of the Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We bless the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And we thank him for his grace.
Yes, yes. Thank you, Lord.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Lord God.
You know, there's no one like our God.
Amen.
No.
Amen.
When you hear the name, when the name is mentioned, there ought to be such a joy that comes out of you.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Because no one was qualified enough to save you and I but Jesus.
Yes, hallelujah. Yeah.
So for anyone to push you to even say, bless the name of Jesus, to thank him, something is wrong with your salvation.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Amen.
Mm-hmm. Just the thought of the name get me excited.
Yes, hallelujah.
I am telling you, because there are a lot of people who didn't make it today.
That's right.
Amen.
Not because we made it, but our name is written in the Lamb Book of Life.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah.
You don't understand. My name, your name, some of your name is written. And I am talking to those who are grateful, and they understand they value such a gift.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Are you with me in here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And while we're here, we might as well do this. Because as you all know, that on the 25th is my father's birthday.
Amen.
Amen. You're still here.
Yes, sir.
Papa Lo, on the behalf of the altar family, I want to say to you, sir, happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Yeah. Hallelujah.
You are one of the greatest father I have ever known.
Amen.
Amen.
I want to thank you for your sacrifice. I want to thank you for your love towards me. I want to thank you for embracing me as a son in the Elias generation.
Amen.
Let me tell you something, Papa. You are a gift to our generation.
Yes. Amen.
I thank the Lord for your humility.
Amen.
Your character. You are what we call the real deal.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
I'm coming to LA to honor you properly. But on the behalf of the altar family, we would like to say to you, sir, Papa Lo, happy birthday. God bless you.
Amen. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Okay, now let's move on.
Amen.
I had to get this on. And I want you to honor the Lord for you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise be to God. Hallelujah. Jesus.
You are a gift. You are a gift to our generation.
Amen.
Thank you. I want you to know that you are a tremendous gift to our generation. And we bless the Lord for you.
Amen.
But I believe tonight that the Lord Jesus is going to bless you. I know tomorrow is chicken day. Is that what we call it? To me, it's simply a big white bird, you know, that's a little bigger than a chicken, okay? You enjoy tomorrow with your family. There will be no dominion tomorrow, but we will be back here on Friday evening. I will be here to minister the word of the Lord to you. But I want to say to you, enjoy that time with your family. I want you to be blessed. Listen to me. I know you're going to go shopping, but go easy on the shopping. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there are some people that make Walmart a tradition. Are you with me? But listen. I want you to enjoy yourself with your family. Have the best meal that you can have with your family, and we look forward to see you again on Friday evening. Are you with me in here? God bless you. Jesus loves you. And now let's go to the word. And I want to thank those who were able to make a contribution to Prophet John Project. God bless you. And the Lord Jesus is going to increase you tremendously for your sacrifice. Amen?
Amen.
God bless you. Now, for those of you Americans who are going to cook tomorrow, can you include some rice? You know, don't just. I know you can have mashed potatoes, but can you include some rice? If you include some rice, I might come by. Are you still here?
Yes, sir.
Let's go to the word of God. I want you to turn your Bible with me, please, to Matthew chapter 26. 26, verse 26. The Lord is going to bless someone tonight.
Amen.
I guess Elder Kerr is the only one who's saying amen. And the Lord Jesus is going to bless someone in this room.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
He is going to bless you.
Yes.
And I want to thank the Lord for the spiritual sons who are all over the planet. God bless you.
God bless you.
Thank you so much. Okay. Elder Carey, read verse 26 for me, please. And then we're going to go to the book of Luke after that, chapter 10, verse 19. Can you read, please?
Yes. While they were eating, Jesus took some bread, and after a blessing, he broke it and he gave it to the disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body. Mm. And when he had...
That's it. That's
fine. Stop right there.
He said... Listen to what she just read for you. Can you read that again for us, please? Matthew 26, verse 26.
Okay. While they were eating, Jesus took some bread, and after a blessing, he broke it and he gave it to the disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body.
Okay. Pastor Issa, I'll go to Luke chapter 10, verse 19 for us, please. Yes, and then Elder Carey, I'm going to have you to go back to Genesis chapter 1, verse 28, please. Read that for us, please.
Yes, sir. Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you.
Okay. First of all, Elder Carey, start from verse 26, Genesis chapter 1, verse 26, 27, and 28. Okay, so it will make sense to a lot of people. Thank you.
Then God said, let us make man in our image, according to our likeness, and let them rule over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the sky, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth. God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, and God said to them, be fruitful and multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, and rule over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the sky and over every living thing that moves on the earth.
Isn't that something? This is really, this is, there's so much meat in some of those verses, pieces of scriptures. It's amazing. When you read Genesis chapter 1, verse 26, 27, and 28, the Bible tells us that it says, God said, let us make men in our own image according to our likeness. Let them rule over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the sky, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth. Did you see that?
Amen.
And then the Bible says, verse 27, God created men in his own image. You were not created in the image of your father and your mother. You were created in the image of God.
Amen.
Amen.
You have God, listen to me, you have God's DNA in you.
Yes.
So you were called to function like God. You were created to function like God.
Amen.
Yes.
Because the Bible says, don't you know that you are what? God.
God.
Are you still here?
Yes.
So, the word us mean Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus was there when you were being created, because Jesus is the Word.
Amen.
You were created in the image of God, in the likeness of God. And look at what it says. In the image of God, he created him, male and female.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
All that time, I'm sorry, Eve was in Adam.
Yes,
but
sir.
The thing, in order for Adam, you wouldn't be in here find Eve, God had to put him to sleep so God could pull out of him what is in him.
Amen.
What was in him. So that's why meditation is really important in the life of a believer.
Amen.
Just stay with me. The Bible says, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Joshua chapter 1 verse 8, Moses, the word of the Lord says to Joshua, this book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth. You shall meditate on the day and night so that you may make your way what? Prosperous.
Yes.
If you are a man or a woman of God, you don't meditate, guess what happened? You will fail. So meditation has to do with what? Thinking. So why is it that every time you get in your car, you're playing your music, you're blasting your music? When do you actually have time to think? Mm. There are too much noise around you.
Yes, sir. Yes.
You need to. You have to be able to think.
Amen.
Amen.
So what meditation does? It brings out the potential in a man or in a woman.
Yes.
You cannot receive what you can listen to me. What you cannot visualize. Or think.
Yes, sir.
Yes, did you hear what I say to you? You cannot receive what you cannot visualize or think.
Yes. Hey. Amen.
Are you still here?
Yes, sir.
Thinking has to do with images.
Mm. Amen.
Mm.
I want you to think tonight, because we are not using the word of God for the purpose of entertainment.
Yes.
We are using the word of God for the purpose of edification.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus said, the word that I have spoken to you, they are spirit and they are life.
Amen.
Yes.
Are you still here?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
And meditation, are you with me in here? You imagine the world, the environment, everything that is in front of you is a result of your meditation.
Mm-hmm.
You have produced what you've been meditating upon.
Amen.
The world, everything, the house you live in, the car that you drive in, even your health, all of this is a result of meditation.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Are you still here?
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So this is why, you know, I don't like religion, because religion will cause you to lose your identity.
My Lord.
That part right there.
Many of you have lost your identity.
Wow.
But God is calling you back to the place. Are you with me in here? To that dimension, the realm of the spirit, where God is a thinking God and He is a generational God.
Yes.
Yes.
The word
yes,
Melchizedek is a two-word, Zedek, which means king and priest. You are a king and you are a priest.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
You're not with me. You're still here.
Amen. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
A new beginning cannot be prayed for. It has to be initiated.
Yes.
Come on in.
Are we together here?
Yes. Yes, sir.
I'm coming. So if you were created in the image of God, you shouldn't be broke. You shouldn't be sick. That's right. Because God is not broke. God is not sick. Sick.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
You are sick as a result of a word. You receive a word from somewhere. And when you receive that word, you start meditating on that word, and that word has no other choice but to manifest in your life. Because the Bible says, as a man think it in his heart, so is he.
Wow. Come on. Come on.
Are you in the end here? So if you spend your time thinking about wealth, guess what happened? You have no other choice but to become wealthy.
Amen.
Listen to me. Listen to me. I got 5 more minutes, because there are some people that cannot discern the will of God for their life. Are you with me in here?
Yes.
So now your appetite has become your God.
Jesus.
Because you cannot discern God in your life. So therefore, your appetite has become your God.
Jesus.
Okay. Let me prove it to you. Pastor Issa, go to Philippians chapter 3, verse 19. I want to show you something. I'm coming. Banda brosia.
Come on.
Makadosh. La brusca.
Yes,
Liban de Brosso Tobohoya, Rapa, Libahai. I'm looking at you. I'm seeing a whole bunch of smoke all around. Esa, put it. Don't touch it. When I saw your name, I saw all the smoke all around you.
Prophesy.
My God.
He knows. We're not gonna go into details. Read, please, Philippians chapter 3, verse 19.
Sir. Whose end is destruction, whose God is their belly, and whose glory is in their shame, who mind earthly things.
He said, did you hear what it says? It says that there are some people whose belly, their belly has become their God.
Jesus.
And your destructions. Are you with me in here?
Yes, sir. My.
Are you with me in here?
Yes, sir.
And then and the destruction is in their shame.
Wow.
Your belly. I don't understand. Everything else, you have given everything else a priority but your relationship with Jesus Christ.
Jesus!
You spent 20 years, 30 years doing things that never brought any glory to God. Now, when you have really don't have much left to give, you want to come and serve the Lord.
With that little stuff. Come on now.
Chase most of your life. You spend most of your life chasing. Have you seen some of those individuals on the road? They are almost running you over.
Jesus.
To get to a job. I'm not saying you're not supposed to work.
Yes.
The Bible says, render to Caesar what belongs to Caesar. Render, give to God what belongs to God. How much of your time have you been spending in the presence of God?
Mm. Come on here, teach.
Because the Bible says, draw near to God, and He will draw near to you.
Amen.
If you are going to be a people, men and women of power, you have got to spend time in prayer.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Are you still here?
Yes.
Jesus, help us. Elder Kerry, go to Acts chapter 13, verse 36. I want to show you something. Thank you, Jesus.
Brethren, sons of Abraham's family, and those among you who fear God, to yes. us the message of this salvation has been sent.
Yes. Did you read, you read Acts 13, verse 36?
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. I have.
Uh-huh.
Okay. For David, after he had served the purpose of God in his own generation, yes. fell asleep and was laid among his fathers and underwent decay.
Mm. Did you hear what the word tells you and I?
Yes. Yes.
David, I need you to listen to the word. David, after he served the purpose of God, after David served the purpose of God, not his house, not his cars, not his money, after he served the purpose of God, so what am I talking about here? When you stand before Jesus, he's going to ask you, did you serve my purpose?
My God.
It did not say his ministry. Let me blow your mind about, let me tell you something about David. Every man in here, you're supposed to function under seven anointing.
Yes.
You're supposed to operate under seven anointing. Number one, I'm not here to entertain you. Number one, David was a king. Amen. He was anointed three times to be a king. Are you with me in here?
Yes, sir. Yes,
number sir. Two, David was a prophet.
Yes.
Number three, David was a warrior. You're supposed to be a king. You're supposed to be a prophet. And you're supposed to be a warrior. You are the best prophet in your life.
Amen.
Amen.
Number
Amen.
Four, David was a psalmist. Number five, David was a poet. Oh, you're still here?
Yes, sir.
He was a psalmist. He was a, no. Number six, he was what, a shepherd. Mm-hmm. Number seven, he was the seventh child. The seventh uh-huh. one.
Hmm.
Where are you in those seven? You're not supposed to have one. You're supposed to function in all seven.
Amen.
Where does it say in the Bible, I'm going to worship God so God can come here? How can God come into his house when this is his house?
That's good.
How can you? How can we worship him so he can come here when this is his house?
That's it.
Amen.
Those statements have driven us further and so and further and further away from God. The Lord Jesus is speaking to you tonight. This is one of the most incredible moments you are having right now in the presence of God. Your existence is defined by the degree you align with the will of God for your life. Did you hear what I just said to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It was Jesus. In the book of Matthew, chapter 26, I'm going to show you how David was able to get to that place where he began to function under those seven anointing. In Matthew 26, verse 26, while they were eating, Jesus took bread. And after he blessed the bread, he broke it. And he gave it to them. He said, "This is my body." Are you still here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
He took the bread. He broke it. And he said to them, "This is my body." Are you still here? If you notice, before the bread was broken, what he did, he took it. He blesses it. And then he broke it. You want to step into your assignment without being broken. You are too emotional. Sit down. Let him break you some more.
Amen.
Took the bread. He broke it. He took it. He blessed it. And then he broke it.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I'm going to show you in somewhere else in the word, the 70 were 70 apostles. When the 70 returned, they said, even the devil was subject to us in your name. That was 70 apostles. That was reduced to what? 12 from 12 to 3. Peter, John, St. James, faith, hope, and love.
Yes.
You're supposed to function under those three grace. Hope, faith, are you with me, and love. Watch this now. He took it, he broke it. In other words, there was a peace for every nation everywhere. So if you cannot sit here and allow God to break you, how do you expect for God to send you to other places, to other nations, other houses, other nations? Are you still here?
Right.
It is through your brokenness that will cause God to take you feed you to other nations. Our nations were calling for your name, but you refused to be broken.
That part right there.
I know. You know why Jesus was enough for the world? Because he allowed himself to be broken. He was the bread.
Yes, sir.
Can I ask you a question? Yeah, you want to preach. You want to be an apostle. You want to be a pastor. You want to be a prophet, but you have not been broken.
Help us, Papa.
You have to be broken.
Amen.
Go deep.
When you show up, you're shedding a fraud and a lie. When you show up, do they see your flesh? Or do they see your What you see here is a result of me being broken. That's my brokenness.
Yes.
Amen.
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 When you are broken, this is so simple. You will begin to operate in power.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, Luke chapter 10, verse 19. Let's go there. This is good stuff. I love it.
Yes, it is.
Luke chapter 10, verse 19. Are you still here?
Yes, sir.
Luke chapter 10, verse 19. Let's go there, please. Any one of the you readers can read it for me. Luke chapter 10, verse 19. Listen to this. Mm-hmm. Thank you,
Behold,
Jesus.
I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you.
Okay, this is where God is going to take some of you. You are going to walk in power and dominion. Let's go back to Genesis. Don't turn your Bible there. Let me take you back to Genesis chapter 1, verse 28. The Bible says he gave them dominion. Didn't he give them dominion? He said, be fruitful, number one. He said, multiply, replenish, subdue it. Are you with me in here? Those are the four things that God told Adam and Eve to do. To be fruitful means to bear fruit. Abundantly. You have to be productive.
Amen.
Very, are you with me? And you're productive in your life. You should always bring result in everything that you do.
Amen.
He said, you have got to be productive. And then he said, multiply. You're supposed to increase. The power of increase is in you.
Amen.
You know why you are not able to access those things? Because of your heart. You have not been broken. And then he said, replenish. In other words, the earth used to be full. Do you know why God was, listen to me, God sent Saul and said, Saul, go kill the Amalekite. Those were the Nephilims.
Yes.
Those were the enemy of God. He said, go kill them. A lot of you are saying, well, how can God be such a cruel God?
There are some, listen to me, God is dealing with some of your enemies tonight. God is dealing tonight with some of your enemies. There are some enemies, you'll never see them again as of tonight. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He said, this enemy you see today, you shall see no more.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus.
There are some things that you could not overcome that used to resist you. But after tonight, as you hear this word, listen to me, the enemy will no longer resist you. Debt will no longer resist you. Listen to me, sickness will no longer resist you. You will have power and authority. Why? Because of your brokenness.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah, God.
He said, subdue it. Control it. Bring it under your subjection.
Yes, sir.
When you begin to operate in those four, are you with me? Your dimension. Principle, you will have dominion.
Amen.
Until you walk in those four dimensions, you will never have dominion.
Yes.
When you can walk in those four dimensions, you will have what? Dominion.
Dominion. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
In the name of Jesus, you will have dominion. And this is the place of power. You can control things. You can tell the devil where to go. And Luke chapter 10, verse 19. Are you with me? And you listen to what it says. Since you're too slow, let me read this for you. Luke chapter 10, verse 19. Listen to what it says. See, I don't have time to sit here. And you see, I'm giving you an opportunity to be blessed. And look what, let's go to verse 17. And when the 70 returned with joy, 70 disciple apostles saying, Lord, even the demons are subject to us in your name, in just the name of Jesus. They were not even filled with the Holy Ghost. They were, listen to me, because he sent them. They obeyed him. They went. They did not ask no question. The problem is you are told to do something. You don't want to do it. You feel like you don't have your so-called leader mentor.
Come on now.
Jesus.
My.
Men and women of power are the most submissive men that I know.
Yep.
I'm older than my father, but I still submit.
That's right.
You want to stand next to greatness? You want to rub shoulders next to with greatness? Learn to submit. You always
that,
have
that part right there. That part right there.
Always have it. But you will submit to something that is crushing, destroying your life. You have no Jesus. Problem submitting to something that brings you pain, distress. See, where I am now, where we are now, listen to me and hear, we can never go back down.
Amen. Amen.
Yes.
The blessings of God are for sure in our lives.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Because of who we are connected to.
Yes, sir. Amen. Amen.
There were some people who didn't even want to talk to Prophet Nas. When they saw who he was connected to, they start talking to him now. Isn't that something?
Deep purple, very deep.
Isn't that something?
My God,
some people
my
are going to come and connect with you because of who you are connected to.
That's right, sir.
You're right. Amen. That's the truth. That's that is true.
I haven't seen nothing yet. You haven't seen. We are going to go to India.
We are going to
have a crusade in India next my year. God.
Amen.
And then we have, and then a door has opened for me in Spain. A door has opened for me in French Guiana.
Amen.
Amen. India. That's why I'm putting a team together. If you cannot listen to what I'm saying to you, you're not going nowhere. Sit down.
You better help right there.
Amen.
It takes someone to come into your life to introduce you to the world.
Amen.
Amen. Oh my God.
It was Simeon that said, behold, the Bible says, behold, the Lamb of God who taketh away the sins of the world. Amen. Somebody had to announce it. As soon as John the Baptist announced Jesus, his ministry was no more.
Yes, sir.
Who announced you? Who introduced you to the world? You introduced yourself.
Right.
You sent yourself. No wonder why no devil is listening to you. No wonder why in the realm of darkness, your name is not registered. Paul, I know. Jesus, I know. But who are you?
Who are you?
You know what I really want to say? It's your name registered in the spirit world.
Amen.
You think it's just about wearing Louis Vuitton sweaters and wearing a Christian Louboutin? No, those things don't make you men and women of God. Or you still make you spiritual.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. My God, you're telling it
tonight. Go deep. Teach.
Yes.
Listen to this, please. He said to them, I was watching Satan fall from fall. Are you still here? From heaven like lightning. Jesus was there when Michael who threw Satan out of heaven. Michael means the one who looked like God.
Yes, yes.
In other words, you can serve God, you can worship God, spend so much time in the presence of God. Mm. You to the point you will lose your natural identity. When people see you, they will see Jesus.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Yes.
The Lord just dropped this in my spirit, Prophet John. He said that the ancients are going to come visit some of you. Moses is going to come visit some of you.
Thank you, Lord.
Because of your level of consecration, your level of consecration will demand for those mental to come into your life.
Yes.
Which means while you're praying, Elijah will come and spend time with you and teach you the word of God.
Yes.
Sister will come, Natalie, to teach you the word. She'll say, No. This is what he means by that.
Yes,
we'll come and visit some of you. The Apostle Paul will come. When you consecrate yourself, you live in that dimension. Because you live in that dimension, your consecration will put a demand.
My God.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Feel the presence of God in you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Father, we bless you. Lift up your hands. You receive. The presence of God is right where you are. Right where you are. Lift up your hands and bless him. Lift up your hands and bless him. Thank you, Jesus. Listen to me. He said, behold, I have given you authority to tread upon a serpent.
Yes.
Treacherous people, men and women. Treacherous men and women. Serpent, that's a terminology. I have given you power to tread upon serpent and scorpion. Serpent and scorpion. Serpent, Nehash. Serpent and scorpion. Scorpion, Scorpius, have given you power to tread upon such an individual. Spirit that manipulate those individuals to behave a certain way. I'm giving you the ability and the right to rebuke them, to put them in their places.
Yes,
when they speak against you, their word will no longer affect you. When they speak against you, their words will no longer affect you. So what used to affect you naturally will no longer affect you anymore. I'm releasing you into that dimension where when you hear what they say, you will no longer be affected by what they say, their opinion. As a matter of fact, they're asking you, why are you where you are now? You are where you are because God sent you. You are going through a wilderness experience. I promise you, give God 8 months from now. God will elevate you. Your name will echo throughout the four corners of the earth. I come to introduce you. Welcome to the next dimension.
Hallelujah.
Your life. In the name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
We're about to fly.
Hallelujah.
Now, as we are about to fly, get ready, Evangelist Manny. Listen to me. Those of you who are part of the inactive group, you are going with me in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Abilities, might, right, rebuke the enemy.
Yes.
Isn't that amazing? When Jesus got off the boat, the first person who recognized him was a demon.
Yes.
Yes,
because
sir.
His name was registered.
Yes.
In the spirit world.
Hallelujah.
When you show up, who recognized you first?
Lord.
Are you looking for people to clap for you, to like you, which means you've been rejected by God?
Yes. Yes. Teach us.
Whenever you're looking for people to clap for you, to accept you, you've been rejected by God. Let me expose some leaders in here. They only come to, you see, they don't show up. They don't tell nobody why. They just go. See, you're not my leader.
Come on now.
Yes.
We are eagles. The eagles have landed.
Hallelujah, God.
Tonight is a night for eagles. Tonight, destiny is changing. It's shifting. I come to introduce you to the spirit world.
Yes.
I come to announce your coming. I come to announce the spirit world that you are here now. Now you are men and women who are going to walk in the power of God. You will no longer be affected by what used to affect you.
Thank you, God.
Jesus loves you.
Thank you, God.
You are healed.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Power have descended upon your life. In the name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
God bless you.
God bless you, Pastor.
Jesus loves you.
God bless you. Happy Thanksgiving.
God bless you, Apostle.
God bless you. Happy Thanksgiving. Let me tell you something. The Lord spoke to me to tell you tonight. You are not the same person who came into this line.
Amen. Hallelujah. I receive it.
You are not the same person. Listen, some of you tonight, when your family members come to visit you in Jesus. A few hours, they are going to look at you and say, I know there's something different about you. Where's Prophet John in here? Where's Prophet John?
Jesus.
Prophet John, where are you? Where are you, Prophet? Prophet John, I was praying about a situation. I am in the U.S. praying about a situation. At 3 a.m. in the morning, I had a discussion with the Lord. Mm-hmm. I was on the chair. When I looked up, I'd been sitting there in prayer for almost 4 hours. Mm-hmm. And the very thing that I discussed with God, Prophet John, tell them what the Lord showed you. Amen. And then a friend of mine said the next day, a few hours after that, said the same thing to me. Share, Prophet John, share with them. I will let them hear it.
Greetings to everyone.
Greetings, Prophet John.
Thank you so much, Papa, for the opportunity that you gave me.
Yes.
Yeah, I was praying and I share with Papa. And I want also to encourage all the leaders and every member of the Halter Church. Because as Papa say, we are in the new season, the season of power.
Amen.
It's true that the season where we are right now, those who are not obedient, they are going to remain behind. We must move with the power of God, the way God wants us to move with Papa. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
So,
amen.
I was praying and I saw Papa was going up on the very huge mountain. And the mountain was very huge. And I saw him was climbing that mountain. And there was a moment it was not easy for him to climb the mountain. So when I was seeing him in the vision, the Lord was telling me that the difficulties and the sacrifice that he was climbing the mountain, that is the huge price that he paid for the ministry, for the work of God.
Amen.
Amen.
And the Lord was telling me that in his life, there was a time of rejection. There was a time of humiliation, but the Lord is going to elevate him. So when I was seeing him climbing the mountain, he reached the top of that mountain. Mm. And the moment he reached the top of that mountain, I saw three people appear on that mountain. Mm. So the three people that appear, I saw one was in front of the two, and those two, they were in the little bit, a small distance. So the one who was in front, he asked Papa to go on his knees And when he went on his knees, he lay his two hands in the head of Papa. So the moment his hands was in contact with the head of Papa, I could see the fire of God. The fire was circulating.
Amen.
His body.
Jesus.
And I could not see the color of the clothes he was wearing or the skin of his flesh, but I was seeing the fire was circulating in all his body. And that man, those three people, they were wearing in the very white garment. The garment was so white, I could not even look at them because of the brightness of the color of the they were wearing. So when he laid hands on Papa, he said three words. He said power, power, and power. Immediately I saw the one who was on the right side, he came with the Bible. So when he reached where Papa was, and that man who was laying hands, he removed his hands. I could see the head of Papa was open. So his head was open. And I saw that person who was on the right side, he came with the Bible, he put the Bible inside of his head. So after putting the Bible inside of his head, that man lay hands, he said, this is the power of the revelation of the word of God. Immediately, I saw the one who was on the left side, who came with a microphone. So he came with a microphone and he gave it Papa Jean. And Papa Jean, he could not hold it because the power of God was so strong over him. And he managed to hold the microphone. And after holding the microphone, that man was praying for him. And he said, let the wonder, the sign, and the miracle of God and the revelation of the word of God accompany you. And after saying those words, immediately I saw Papa Lavi. He was behind Papa Jean. And those three people, they disappeared. So Papa Lavi was helping Papa Jean to stand up. When he stood up, I could see down on that mountain, I could see a crowd of people, thousands of people, the way running, going up where Papa was. And Papa Lavi, he said, my son, this is the time, go. And after Papa Lavi, he said that word, the Spirit of God was telling me that this season is the season where God is introducing Papa Jean, is the season of power, because with his hands, the fire which was coming on his hands, and the Lord was saying, there is no power of this world are going to resist before him. Fire which was coming out of his mouth. So the Lord was saying that in this season, no spirit in this world will resist his ministry. Because God said that after that, God was telling me that some of us, we are blessed because we are not going to start life, even the ministry, from scratch. Papa, he already carried us from his shoulder. And the Lord was saying he's going to make things easy for many people who will be obedient to the ministry of Papa. Those who are obedient, they will see even in their life a lot of things, people, they're still struggling to see breakthrough. But the Lord is saying to the leaders or anyone on this platform to be obedient. And if you're obedient to God through the ministry, you will see how God will bless you. So that is what I saw and I share with Papa. Thank you so much, Papa.
Amen. 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 That's the conversation I was having with the Lord. I said, if they can find John in the wilderness, if they can find John in the wilderness, then they need to find us wherever you place us.
Amen.
Amen.
My God. My God.
Wherever you are, they will find you.
Yes.
My God, you're right.
Wherever you are, they will find you. Wherever you are, they will find you.
Yes, Lord.
They will find you.
My God.
And they will bring you the spoil.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Moderator, let's give tonight. This is going to be a Thanksgiving offering. Come on in, moderator. Prophet John, thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Dr. Denise, may I say something real quick?
No, not now.
I tried to. Okay.
Apostle said this is a Thanksgiving offering. This is a Thanksgiving offering. We're giving our thanksgiving unto the Lord. So let's do that. Let's do it now. Let's prepare our hearts and minds and let's do it. Be obedient to what Apostle Gene Elias has instructed us to do. We want you to give your best, to sow your best. Those of you that can sow 5,000, do that. 6,000, 10,000, do that. 1,000, do that. Those of you that can sow 100 or more, do that. Yes, do that. Thanksgiving. There's no amount that we can possibly give God that God hasn't already given us. So that's a blessing for our Lord. Let's do that for him right now. And moderator, if you would please put up on the screen so we can explain exactly the various different ways for some of the new people that are on the line. God bless you. And some of the folks that have not sown before, and for some of us, this is a reminder, get your cell phones. You can use your cell phones as that point of contact, that point of sale, that point in which you're sowing your seed, sowing that sacrificial seed, that Thanksgiving seed today. You can do it by going to PayPal. You can go to PayPal and put in prayer time with the apostle. Again, prayer time with the apostle. And there on PayPal, you can sow your seed. You can sow your seed there. Or you can go to prayertimewiththeapostle.com, our website, prayertimewiththeapostle.com. And there is a donate button. You click the donate button and it will take you immediately to PayPal where you will be able to sow that Thanksgiving seed today. Yes. For those of you that go to TAI Church, to that website, you can also sow there at www.taichurch.com. Again, www.taichurch.com. There's a QR code, just like you see here on the line, on the screen. You can take your cell phone and you can put your camera function and you can scan it. When you scan it, it'll take you directly where you will be able to sow your seed. Yes, that's right. For those of you that have Cash App, the $ Apostle of Cash. Again, the $ Apostle of Cash. Then you'll also see the robe, a beautiful blue robe that he's in with the gold piping around it. And you'll see him and he then will be able, you'll know that that's definitely where you are. You're in the right place. You're in the right place. Forgive the noise behind me. You're in the right place. Again, $ Apostle of Cash. Yes. Those of you that would like to send it by mail, P.O. Box 1745, Upper Marlboro, Maryland, zip code 20773. Again, P.O. Box 1745, Upper Marlboro, Maryland, zip 20773. Yes, and make sure that this is your Thanksgiving in the memo sections. Make sure you put the Thanksgiving offering, your Thanksgiving seed, your Thanksgiving seed that you're sowing. Yes, and make sure that the blessings of the Lord are sealed over your life today. God bless you all. Elder Carey, if you would please come in at this time and give us various ways in which to connect to the ministry of the Altar Church and to Apostle of Cash. Yes.
Yes. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Dr. Denise. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Apostle, for that powerful, powerful word. And thank you, Prophet John. Thank you as you prophesize over our spiritual father and that which God have revealed and has showed you. And that was just, you know, God is just an awesome God. And so we thank God for the word that have come forth. So on behalf of our spiritual father, our prophet, our man of God, Apostle Gene Elias, we thank God for each and everyone who have joined us, Dr. Denise, Elias, the leadership of the Altar International Church, our grandfather in the faith. We give them honor and we just thank God for what God is doing, for what God is doing in this hour, at this specific time. We also thank God for the brothers and sisters of the ministry, the sons and the daughters, and everybody who have joined us. We thank God for Prophet Nass and Pastor Sylvester and Prophet John and Evangelist Mommy and those who all have joined us here on YouTube and Instagram and Twitter and TikTok and Facebook. We thank God for each and every one of you. And so the way to connect with this ministry is to go to YouTube. And at YouTube, you can subscribe to Apostle of Cash. At YouTube, you can subscribe with live stream videos by going to Apostle of Cash. Also, you can take and you can go to Twitter and Instagram by using the at sign Apostle of Cash, @ApostleofCash. And then you have Facebook. And you just go Apostle of Cash. Once you go into the search, you go Apostle of Cash. And then TikTok, @ApostleofCash. TikTok, @ApostleofCash. And also, you can always email us at altarchurch77@gmail.com. So tonight, you want to get the message. You want to get that recording because this is our miracle night service. And so as our very own apostle, he had shared these words and he said that, you know, first of all, we must connect with the word of God. I have given you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions. And tonight is a night for us, the word prophetic, the declaration is that we are eagles. We are men and women who walk in the power of God. You have to receive that in your spirit. There's a new season. He said that we are eagles. Wherever you are, they will find you and bring this forth. That's the declarated word that our apostle brought us. Wherever you are, they will find you and bring this forth. He talked about meditation. He talked about the seven anointings of man. He talked about brokenness and the dimensions of the principles and learning submission. And that's something that he stresses all the time. So get a copy of this. And when you get a copy, you want to share. Share with that loved one. This is a time of Thanksgiving. Share it with that family member. Share it with a friend. Share it with a neighbor. Go into the grocery store. Just share it and say, here, there's a link that you can connect where God is speaking to the Altar International Church. And as we always said, if you do not have a home church, you can take and you can email us at prayertimewiththeapostle.com. Again, that's prayertimewiththeapostle.com. Or also, if you need someone to pray with you, remember prayertimewiththeapostle.com. That's the way that you can connect, or either go to altarchurch77@gmail.com. altarchurch77@gmail.com. And you know, no one should be without a covering. And as you heard what God is doing, some amazing things. And even as we approach 2023, you don't want to miss it. You don't want to miss it. Also, you can come and connect at the healing room. And at the healing room, every morning at 7:15 a.m. for the morning devotion, every Monday through Friday, even though tomorrow's Thanksgiving, but you know, so they won't be there tomorrow, but no Friday, the healing room at 7:15 a.m. Then, you know, be with us here. Join us here on Friday. I'm missing a day here. on Friday, because tomorrow is Thanksgiving, so we will not be having Dominion Hour, but Friday is our Friday night miracle service. And as Apostle said, he will be here Friday for a word, for an incredible word. And then on Sunday, we have our Sunday morning virtual worship service, Sunday morning at 11 o'clock a.m. And then back again on Wednesday, we have our midweek service as you're here tonight. Then Thursday, we have our Dominion Hour, an hour of prayer. And so we just thank God how his God is moving mightily. May God bless you. May each and every one of you have a blessed and a thankful for what God has done, and allowing God to do what he needs to do through us, to purify us, to do what God needs to do, to have us to receive what our man of God. Keep him in prayer and his family, Dr. Denise and Jessica, as they go through and spend time for Thanksgiving. So may God bless you. And at this time, I'm going to turn it back over to Dr. Denise. We can't hear you, Dr. Denise.
Okay. God bless all of you that are on YouTube, all of you that are on every social media platform. God bless you. May you have a marvelous Thanksgiving. Those of you that are on Zoom, God bless you, leaders. May you and your families experience a wonderful, wonderful Thanksgiving. May the presence of the Lord be yours. Just as Apostle has administrated, he proclaimed a blessing over our lives. Every leader, the blessing over your lives. Those of you that have come together and that have sacrificed, God bless you. Those of the, that have sown that Thanksgiving seed, God bless you. Those of you that intercede and pray for Apostle and the ministry on a daily basis in your time of prayer, we salute you as well. We thank God for your sacrifices. We thank God for where you are, and we celebrate the Lord with you. God bless everyone at the sound of my voice. And Mr. Campbell, please, will you come back in on Wednesday and afford us the opportunity of hearing that testimony, please, or sending an email to alterchurch77@gmail.com. Again, alterchurch77@gmail.com. So then we'll make sure that we will get your testimony in. We'll make sure. God bless everybody at the sound of my voice. Enjoy your Thanksgiving. Hug somebody for me. Hug somebody for the rest of the family. Leaders, hug your families and be there for your families. Pray over them and know that God is going to do something mighty. God bless you all. Moderator, take it away.
Amen. Yes.
Satan fall like lightning. I saw darkness run for cover. But the miracle that I just can't get over, my name is registered in heaven. I believe in signs and wonders. I have resurrection power. Yes, I do. My story. story.